Israel will launch a ground offensive in Rafah regardless of the success of truce talks. That was the message from Prime Minister Netanyahu in a meeting with bereaved families and relatives of hostages. Two IDF divisions stand ready as Israel awaits an answer from Hamas on the ceasefire for hostages deal that would delay the Rafah operation. More from ILTV's Steve Leibowitz.
Prime Minister Netanyahu vowed that Israel will launch a ground offensive in Rafah regardless of the success of truce talks. Speaking in a meeting with bereaved families and relatives of hostages opposed to a deal with Hamas that would end the war in Gaza before the terror group has been eliminated, Netanyahu said, "The idea that we will stop the war before achieving all of its aims is not an option. We will enter Rafah and we will eliminate Hamas battalions there, whether or not there is a deal, in order to achieve total victory." The latest offer for a hostage deal being mediated in Cairo reportedly includes a 40-day pause in fighting and the release of almost 1,000 Palestinian prisoners in exchange for between 20 to 33 hostages. The numbers relate to hostages in a so-called humanitarian category, women, children, men over 50, and those who are sick. Mediators are still waiting for an answer from Hamas. Israeli negotiators will return to the talks only if the answer is positive. If the answer is negative, the way is cleared for a Rafah operation to begin. IDF forces are already prepared for the Rafah operation. Division 162 withdrew from Gaza after 6 months of intense fighting in the north and center of the Strip. Division 98 ended its prolonged combat in Gaza after 4 months of maneuvering in Khan Yunis. Both divisions are expected to return to Gaza for the Rafah operation, and they are ready. The forces worked on strengthening their competence in preparation for the continuation of the war in the Gaza Strip while learning lessons from the war so far.
Israel Bonds, the heartbeat of solidarity, the powerhouse of support. When the Hamas-Israel war hit, Israel Bonds stood tall, proving we're more than just an investment, we're a lifeline. Investing in Israel Bonds isn't just a financial move, it's a declaration for resilience, strength, and a better future for Israel. Join us and let solidarity echo through generations.